Walkout! Yeah. Right. Yeah. 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 I started off here. I'm undocumented. I had to pay out-of-state tuition. That was about $3,000 my first semester. And I had to deal with it. You know, I had the entire semester to pay it off. But as soon as the administration pulled this payment policy because of everything that was happening with the accreditation commission, they decided that they wanted to charge all their students their tuition up front, or else, guess what, you get dropped. So having to pay $1,000, $2,000, $3,000 up front is not how you access education. The payment policy has dropped the enrollment drastically. It makes students not be able to go to city colleges if they cannot afford it, whether it may be $200 or $3,000 that they have to pay up front. There's just no money for that. Not everybody qualifies for financial aid. How many of y'all, like, went over your financial aid already?
Yeah.
Woo! Exactly. So we're the ones that are being directly affected because of the payment policy.
Hi y'all, thanks for being here. My name is Jahaira.
Thank you for being here. Hola. I just want to say they're cutting down these classes, our diversity studies classes. Really think about that. What are they trying to say? They're trying to erase your history. They're trying to say that we're not important, that our history and our people aren't important, that we don't need these classes. Like, there's, who needs them? We do. This is empowering. Don't let them take that away from you. That's all I want to say.
So we stand here today asking for three things. We're asking for the immediate removal of the special trustee.
He has ultimate power over CCSF. Even with the board of trustees, he still has veto power over any decision that they make. So that means one person over the entire city college. What do you guys think about that? Second demand, to restore all of the cuts that have been happening to the classes and the resource centers here on campus. Third demand, to get rid of the payment policy, which has definitely been affecting students of color and students' ability to access education at City College of San Francisco. I'm going to introduce Professor Tariq. She is the Department Chair of African American Studies. Tariq, can we get you up front, please?
Given full accreditation.
bingo card, one step away from being closed. The result of that decision, those decisions, thousands of students in the state are suffering. Thousands of students. And many thousands of field colleagues that were, you know, that were ripped off by a corrupt business style institution. And we know the story of field colleges. And the thousands that have suffered, 30,000 students are no longer here at CCSF. The problem with CCSF was that we did not have the business model here. What was so attractive about Keele's College, the ABCJC, was that they were the epitome of a business model.
We can hear you very well.
Yes.
So can you hear me now?
Yeah.
Okay. So what is happening here at CCSF?
Louder.
The way that the school is being transformed is to be like
Louder.
Your college.
Right? Does this one work better?
Can you hear me now?
Yeah. Speak up. Project.
Raise up. Boys up.
Stay with your chest.
Okay. So what I was saying is that the model that the ABCJC is pushing, the model that the school did not have, which led to its being sanctioned, was the model of education that we see or saw at Yale College at Creighton. CCSF had a model which put you, students, at the center, which put the interests of the community more broadly, the desires of the community more broadly at the center. That's not what this model is about. The transformation is going on here now. The people who are in charge of this school, we have to understand, are people who were appointed, you know, by state chancellor to essentially bring about that transformation. The people who hired the present administrator, the high administrator, the special trustee, who is now gone. They have another special trustee with that story for college. He was elected by no one. He was appointed by the state chancellor, Bryce Harris, who was elected by no one. What the special trustee with extraordinary power did is one of its first acts was to dissolve the elected board of trustees. He dissolved an elected board who was elected by no one. This is the type of administration that is the model that we're supposed to follow here. And that's what's being imposed here in the school right now. Saying loud. Education. no post office, no health care, right? No jobs, but plenty of prisons. You know, plenty of police with plenty of guns, right? You know, to put, you know, to the ones that they don't, ones of the youth that they don't put in the grave, then they can put in prison.
Right.
This is their vision of the world. They don't think about it that way. This is the world that they want to create. The only people who can stop them are you. Right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Coalition.
So as a student here at City College of San Francisco, through Ethnic and Diversity Studies, I learned the importance of alliance building. In the classes, we discussed about the crucial role of alliance building in order to unite, empower, liberate, and heal from micro-individual level to macro-institutional level, as well as meso-community level oppression. Through those classes, I learned to maneuver through my life and connect my experiences into those narratives. I also learned the importance of community and cultural humility in which perpetuates effective interactions and notions in my daily life. Moreover, when we discuss of alliance building, the alternative narrative usually refers to the notions of working together in a manner that benefits the community. Meaning, alliance building is a crucial in making and creating changes that benefits not only the individual, but the larger community as well. However, alliance building is nuanced as it is extremely complex. It takes practice and a process-oriented notion in which theory, reflection, and action simultaneously occurs to promote a cycling and forever fluid notion that creates unity, empowerment, liberation, and healing. The tenets or pillars of unity, empowerment, liberation, and healing are the many components of alliance building. Connecting this notion to CCSF, we as diverse individuals need to form alliances and be in solidarity with one another to create a change that will not only benefit those people in power, but those who need it the most.
Sorry. Yeah.
Queer people, trans individuals, women, people of color, lifelong learners, low-income people, undocumented students are some of those people we need to think about when we are building alliances. Furthermore, in this particular context, we need alliances here at CCSF to promote a more beneficial outcome to people who are oppressed, people who are marginalized. We need to build alliances to transform lives, to transform communities, to perpetuate healing from intergenerational trauma and intergenerational anger. We need alliance building to unite our community, to gain community and share power, to liberate from the constrictions of isms and to heal from our fallen dreams that have been shattered into pieces. We need alliance building to create change and to help our communities and ourselves. The shared community power that is created can make an impact. It can change lives, communities, and even systems themselves. Through alliance building, individuals acknowledge their histories and share commonalities. They can utilize this notion to foster essential conversations that perpetuate micro to macro healing and liberation. In other words, alliance building fosters that can be equalized to power dynamics here at CCSF and in our society. We can use this power to transform and change laws, hegemonies, ideologies, and policies that have been placed to oppress us. Though our history tells us that we have been oppressed in diverse ways, whether that's through exclusion, police brutality, slavery, incarceration, genocide, war, gentrification, we are resisting and forever be moving towards justice and equity.
Yeah.
We are moving towards the equity and empowerment of our communities and our students. So through alliance building, we can connect micro to macro, connect our lives to Baltimore, to Palestine, to Ferguson, to anywhere there is injustice in the world. We can be more aware and reflective on those events that are occurring past to present. Similar to what Martin Luther King Jr. said, injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. In order to move towards hope and optimism. With that said, there is injustice here at CCSF. With uncovering our resource centers, revising the mission statement, to the imbalance of power of the super trustee, to the downsizing of the college, when are we going to say enough is enough? When are we going to stand up for what is ours? Who is going to do it for us? For our community, for our friends, for our families, for our students, for our faculty, when? Why not now? Consequences. Alliance building creates all these notions that will foster the growth of this institution. I hope to see one day that when we unite and liberate and empower, in which we can triumph against these oppressions and aggressions the administration has imposed against our students, our faculty, our community, and our beloved San Francisco itself. And that I hope together we will heal from our fallen dreams and start new dreams filled with hope and optimism. Thank you so much for your time.
A little more juice right now.
Yeah.
I don't know about you, but
enough.
Yeah.
When you hear me say I've had enough about all the crazy crap going on around here, I want you to chant enough.
Yeah.
Can I hear enough?
Yeah. Yeah.
So have you had enough of push-out policies?
Yeah. Shut up.
Have you had enough of push-out policies when the college needs more students, not less students?
Enough!
Have you had enough of teachers who are going to get laid off because they can't make the right plans to come up with an enrollment plan?
Enough!
Have you had enough of administrators making bad decisions by giving themselves raises and saying everybody else can't have one?
Enough!
Had enough of them denying your educational opportunity?
Enough!
I've had enough too.
Enough!
I gotta tell you a little bit of story here, because I tell you there's one group we've really had enough with, and that is the ACCJC. We've had enough with them. So you gotta know what's happening. We gotta call for an investigation of what happened at Heald College. They went ahead and gave that Heald College the accreditation, and Barbara Bino, I want to hear a boo.
Woo!
Barbara Bino said the other day in the newspaper, well, it wouldn't have really been fair to look at the accreditation of Heald College after because somebody else bought them. What? So somebody said in the newspaper, in reply to that, they said, so you mean if the mafia decided to buy your college, it would be okay with them?
Yeah.
Enough! Enough with the ACCJC! Enough! Enough!
Enough! Enough! Enough! Enough! Enough! Enough! Enough! Enough! Enough!
I'm trying to be heard. Can you hear me?
Yeah!
I'm here as a part of the larger coalition to start with Saving City College, right?
Yeah!
We are here for the Performing Arts and Education Center because it's the first step in a design to deprive us of resources that have been planned in the master plan for years and years and years. And once they start that domino effect, they take the parking lot next. And then they decide that because there aren't enough classes to maintain activity in classrooms, they'll start loaning out those classes in a private-public partnership. You ever heard of that? And then industry will come and occupy, you ever heard of occupy?
Yeah.
Our property, our land, our school, in the interest of private interest, and reducing and shrinking our claim to this public property. This is a school, say it with me, of the people.
Of the people.
By the people.
By the people.
For the people.
For the people.
This school belongs to us.
This school belongs to us.
And now they have imposed a special trustee. Well, let's talk about that for just a second. When you pay your tuition, when I pay mine, I trust that it will be spent on educating me, correct? When I go to class with our wonderful faculty, I trust that they're going to teach me in a competent way, correct? When I buy a book, I trust it's going to be the right book for the right class, correct? So we behave interactively with our faculty, our staff, ourselves as students, our fellow students, our laboratory managers, our police who are supposed to protect this campus. All of us operate on the basis of trust, correct?
Yes.
So who are the special trustees?
We are.
The special trustees, please raise your hand. Special trustees of CCSF. Don't let anybody tell. Let's reclaim that title. That belongs to us. We are the special trustees. We are the people for whom this school was built. We're here to protect it. We're here to own it. We're here to claim it. We're standing on our ground. And we are the special trustees. Let's say it one more time.
We are the special trustees.
And we will see to it that our elected trustees, who will represent us, the special trustees, are in their places as soon as possible. Do we agree? We're going to demand restore the trustees. Say it with me, please.
Restore the trustees.
And who said so? The special trustees. We did.
The PAC followed Chinatown as the next building to be built. Without it, we do not have a complete campus. There are two more buildings on that master plan that were agreed to by the Bond Commission in 2008. Since then, they have messed around with us through administration after administration and turned us down for 15 bloody years. Twice voted by voters in San Francisco and two bond measures. The voters are still paying. That means you, your parents, your grandparents, for PAC through their taxes, the Performing Arts Education Center. Is there a lawsuit we see in the future here?
Yes!
You cannot deny the voters of San Francisco what is their legal right.
Yes!
From a community college position, the campus is not complete. Without practice rooms, which Helena Calidra's now addressed, the campus is not complete without concert halls that have acoustics that are decent. Electronic music. This is an electronic age, right? I'm reminded of that continually. And places to meet that go beyond music and other arts. All functions of a community college, meeting with diversity, bringing all the people that want to perform here from all the different communities that have spoken to us here in a decent and fine facility. We need it. We don't need the gym as much as we need that. We are here today to stand together with the CCSF coalition. We stand for diversity. We stand for everything that you stand for. We also stand for art, which brings us all together through dance, through music, through speaking, through all the history of this art college. Diversity. Diversity. People of ages working together, all ages. I just came back from a campus, off-campus Jewish community center, where I work with my students, and they're translating what I do with them on Tai Chi Chi into Russian. That is part of our diversity. We are everywhere in this community, not just here. Seven campuses, many outlying campuses. You all know of them. Your parents, your grandparents go there for free. So as we work together, our history of bringing people together as a college, the sciences, technology, and everything else, including working with 95-year-olds, we are not standing just for STEM, science, technology, engineering, math. We are standing for STEAM, which is science, technology, engineering, art. We educate the whole person of all ages, all diversity at this college. Let's not let them break us down to 18 to 24-year-olds or to only private techies that have taken over our city. As we educate the whole person at City College of San Francisco and we stand for the Performing Arts and Education at this time, I wanted to say that that is your heritage, not just ours. This building will belong to the whole college. You will have a place for all the things that you love to do. And on that note, I'd like to introduce Helena Calidra.
City College of San Francisco, thinking that we had an art
a degree in vocal performance, and there isn't. And it's really messed up, because we were supposed to have this this amazing building that's been planned for like over 10 years. And if we would have had that, then we would have had enough practice rooms and places for people like me, an 18-year-old Latina that has been in the public school system my entire life and can't afford to go to a conservatory for all 4 years. And so I'm just here to sing you a little bit of what, you know, what talent we have at this amazing institution. So this is an excerpt from one of the operas by Leo Delibes, and it's called Lachme, and this is the bell song. Woo!
STEM Center, the astronomy department. So I'm here to represent all of the minority students that are trying to get an education in science. The fact is that even though they're also petting all of our diversity, they're also petting all of our science classes, something that is also not talked about. Because if it wasn't for STEAM, I wouldn't have found my place in the astronomy department. If it wasn't for my Chicano studies that helped me empower myself as a Mexican American and know that I can pursue science, I wouldn't be here right now.
Yeah.
They have given so many of us the opportunities that we weren't given from the public education system, then where the hell will we be in the future? This is our only community college, and they're trying to take it away from us. We need all of us to be part of this school, not just diversity, but science as well. And I'm so glad to see Dr. Price here from the Queen Mary. And I'm thankful to see everyone here. We need all the support. We need to keep this school open. We need to fight for our rights. We need to stop trying to save our money on education because this is a community college. The main word, community. Yeah, stop taking the community out of college. So, okay, can everybody hear me?
Yeah!
Even in the back row, because I have something important to say.
We do!
Okay, first of all, I want to say that I met Esther because she joined WISE, Women in Science and Engineering. And I had no idea that she had to struggle to get to be in a place where she was studying science here. So I just want to say, yay, City College, for being there for her.
Yeah!
College that offers opportunities for everybody, not just people in science, not just people that can afford it, not just the students that can make it out in 2 years. We're here for everybody, and so we have to ask ourselves, why is this happening to us? Why are the decisions that our administration is making, why are they doing this? And the reason, there's a lot of reasons, but it goes back to the accreditors and the agenda that the accreditors are putting forward. And who are these accreditors? The ACCJC. Well, let me tell you just a couple of facts about them. In August 2013, who are these people? I started looking into it, and it turns out that they have ties to the student loan industry. They have an agenda, which is to downsize City College. I say downsize the ACCJC. So since then, there's been a lawsuit where they have been found guilty of violating federal and state law. They have been sanctioned by the Department of Education, which is the people that give them their authority. And they've been put on their own show cause. So they're going to come up before the Department of Education in December of this year to try to justify why they shouldn't have their own
down the ACCJC.
We gotta now
see
CSF.
What they had that they imposed on them.
Yeah. Becky, bring back the 40 counselors that they removed from this campus. Becky, bring back the over 400 faculty that were laid off. We don't even have permanent faculty in most of our diversity studies courses.
What?
And they're also, they have shitty pay. They have to overwork. We as students have to actually help enroll for the classes. You see, a bunch of the hallways lined up with pink slips saying that they've actually cut due to low enrollment. Why is the enrollment low? The payment policy was imposed on this college campus. The claim was there was about $5.2 million to $7 million that the school was in debt for. They claim that it was the students' fault, that it was them being in debt that made the school financially unstable. That is a lie. Now, what the school has taught us, the faculty, is to critically think. Well, the reality is that in the past 4 years, that the state has divested $63 million from this college, and we've actually lost thousands of students more from the payment policy. So, if you look at the numbers, $7 million in 10 years, $63 million in 4. It was, now, they claim that the average amount that the student owes is about $280. And that the most that one student owes is about $3,000. Guess how much it costs, or guess how much we get from the state if a student is enrolled at City College? $4,600. It makes 4 cents. A student enrolled full time that it makes for them to get kicked out of the college. So you must ask yourself, why is it that they're kicking us out? Now, it doesn't make sense, but it does make sense to their cost. In order for them to rationalize and justify the cut, in order for them to make sure that people aren't pissed off, well, they're going to claim that there aren't enough students in the class enrolled. There aren't enough students going to the resources. There aren't enough LGBTQ. URC. No one's going to African American studies anymore. That's why we have to cut it, because it's wasting $1,000.
Special Trustee has got to go. Ho, ho, ho. attacking black people. They're eliminating.
Continue
you organizing